For those of you who are skilled in cooking, you know that every ingredient matters. If you miss out on a few ingredients, then it'll show up in the way the dish turns out. And if you miss out on a lot of ingredients, it can end in a complete disaster. So we are looking at each of these ingredients, and the ingredient that we are looking at right now is the ingredient of love. Now, there are different kinds of love that are listed in the Bible. Different words, different Greek words that talk about different kinds of love. There's affection, brotherly love, or passionate or physical love. And there is this sacrificial, unconditional love, which is called agape. So different kinds of love that are listed there. And this agape seems to be a word that is uniquely there in the Bible, a sacrificial, unconditional, selfless love. It's a unique love because it's a in spite of love. It's a love which says, I will love you in spite of who you are. I will love you in spite of what you do. And it's a total opposite of a love which says, I will love you because you have this. You know, in the world, we have a love which says, I will love you because you have these qualities. I love you because you do this for me. I love you because you bring this into my life. But this love, agape, is a total opposite of that. It says, I will love you in spite of, despite who you are, I will still love. And this is the kind of love that God has for us. This is the kind of love that God shows us and God extends to us. And this is an important ingredient to have in our lives, to add to our faith, that we will move from a selfish, conditional love to a selfless, in spite of, unconditional love. 1 Corinthians 13 describes love. It says, love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself, is not puffed up, does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, is not provoked, thinks no evil. Love does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things, and this love never fails. So this scripture portion actually describes the God kind of love, the kind of love that God has for us. This love is patient, which means that it is never impatient, it waits. This kind of love is kind. There's kindness in speech because of this love. There's kindness in action because of this love. This kind of love does not envy. It's not selfish. It's not self-seeking. It's not jealous. This kind of love is not proud. It does not behave rudely, is not selfish. It is not provoked. This kind of love does not celebrate or enjoy iniquity. And this love bears, hopes, endures, and it never runs out. So in 1 Corinthians 14 and verse 1, Paul writes and he says, pursue love. Go after this kind of love or this quality of love. Let this be a pursuit to, let this be our pursuit to develop this kind of love in our own lives. And 1 John 3 and verse 18, John says, my children, let us not love in word or in tongue. Let it not just be a matter of speech. Let it not be something of discussion. But, he says, in deed and in truth. Therefore, this ingredient, love, a very important one, and something that will really strengthen our lives, something that will enable us to really display who God is to other people. So let's pray and ask God that this love will be developed in us, that we will move, we will make that shift from a selfish love to an unconditional love. Father, we thank you that you love us, God. We thank you that your word says that you loved us so much that you gave your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in you will not perish, but have everlasting life. And Father, we thank you. You gave because of that love. And Lord, I pray that that kind of love will be built in us, Lord. Your word says that you poured out that love in our spirit, by the work of your Holy Spirit. And I pray that this love will find expression through our lives in what we say and what we do. We give you thanks. We give you all praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.